So, okay guys, I show you now how to install the Hellscope system. It's already installed in my car and I now remove it to go back to stock, and then you can see how I install the Hellscope in the system. It's not very difficult, but hey, a little video may help you. Okay, here we go. The mini connectors is because I have the DTOC tuning box installed, so I have a little more plugs to open than normal. Okay, now open the hose because it's easier to install all. Okay, it's a box. So, RKS panel filter. That's a little help for security, but not really necessary. Well, these are the three parts of the Hellscope system with the HKS panel filter. Okay, now we replace stock parts. Okie dokie. We only make it to show you how it works. That's the original lower part of the air intake system. It's fixed in this three holes. For this three things. I mounted only it with a few screws. Okay, so it's this one. Now the parts for the intake. This is the old one. One is in the okay. The hose for the flap to open. Okay, that's it. So your car look or should look like this if you are on stock. Okay. Now we remove the parts you need to install the new Halescope system. Okay. Now the scoop, easy to remove. There are two plastic screws to remove here. Then with these clips left and right to remove the other part. Now remove the hose from this relay and the other one. Also, remove the switch for the flap. Better just secure the screw. Okay. Now, remove the plug from the MAF sensor. You have also to remove the thing from the then open the airbox, remove the upper part. The lower part is a little, you need a little force to lift it. So now we have to remove it. That's the second part you don't need anymore because the third part. Okay, now replace the upper part. You now have to install the security part. I have a new one that have a little hint for the side you should install here front. Looks so. Now comes a little tricky part to put the it's better to don't install the upper part yet. Okay, the front one, this one. And now comes the tricky part to put the screw just out. This time I have luck and the bolts don't fall down to the engine undercover tray, so you have to remove the under tray. Okay, now we secure a little bit the hole. Okay, So now again the upper part. Now the lower part. Okay. You have to remove these clips. It's not very difficult, but you need a little force. So you have it. And on the other side, a little force downward. So you have it. Okay. Now you have these two parts. And now you have your brand new Hellscope system lower part. You have to clip it in and then the other side, clip it in. Your panel filter, whatever you prefer, RKS, ETS. Okay, now push it up a little bit downward. Keep attention that the clips don't fall down. Now you fix it on the back parts, clip it in. Now clip close the part, close this one. So the most one is fixed. The second one is to fix the cable here. Now you relieve from the. So you have to mount it. The screw. Keep attention to the screw don't fall down, or you have to lift your car. Okay, now let's fix it. This one. If you have to this right position, you can now install the new scoop. Oh, here it is. New system, maximum opening. Okay, now you can fix it with this bolt and this nut. And then lift it up a little bit. It's better to a little bit here and a little bit there. Then you need to fix your little hose. Okay, if you have it in the right position, then you have to screw your hose clamps both and set the thing up in the position. Okay. Looks like with my hose it's a little bit better. I will now remove the upper part and install the other hose. Mm-hmm. keep attention, don't lose the Okay, big mounted again. Now the hose for the flip that you don't need, but the ECU needs the info if the flip is open and ready to release more power. Okay, you push it back on the first part, and on the second who goes normally to the flap, you have to close it. It's important to close it and not let it open. So where have I put this little hose part. Here is it. Remove it from your original part. A tie tip does the trick. Close the hose. Close the hose. And now close the hose and tighten it as much as possible. So that's enough to close the flap part. So we cut it a little bit. Zack. Okay, now back to our connector. Okay, now the ECU thinks the flap is still open and releases as much power as it's possible. You can fix the cables in this hole on the side. Now back to the connectors for the muff. As I said, I have the D-Tuck box installed. So I have to install the D-Tuck box cable first, and then the cable coming from the engine. But if you don't have a detox box, you can direct the connect. Okay, I connect back my detox box and the detox box with the MIPS sensor. Okay, looks okay. It's all fine. It's not more that holds the whole system. You are now finished. If you have any question, you know, you can contact me via WhatsApp, YouTube, Instagram, Facebook. I hope you have the same fun as I have, and via my Dyno measurement, it releases 10 horsepower. With the detox box, stage 2. Okay, it's also easy to rebuild to stock if you wish. Keep attention that you don't lose these clips. They are falling often down to the engine cover, and you have to lift the car and remove the engine cover to go back to these things. So the detox box is at this part. Well, that's it.